What's your plan? Is it plain? On a plane? Hydroplane? I'm just playing. What's your purpose? What's your passion? Did it pay? What's your plan? Is it plain? On a plane? Hydroplane? I'm just playing.
I mean, it's something about a fresh line. Make a man feel like $1 million. Fresh fade, get the tape or the shadow on it. Them waves so deep, you need a paddle for them. I mean, it's more than just hair. It's the confidence you feeling when you step up out that chair. And I swear, they tell me every bob is mean. From Trav, Herm, B to Sayyid, now say hello to the team. Cause the style supreme, my nigga, don't forget the style supreme. They know the style supreme, supreme style. Keep the whole town clean, get a can of that sheen. Spray it on me, make me feel like a king.
Like a king.
That's what I mean by gold dreams. And they gon' get up on this smooth shit one day. And you could even bang this cut on a Sunday, Monday. A bunch of Blake Griffins with them clippers. A Chris Paul throwing lives to us all. It's more than a cut, you don't need no stitches for this.
Nah.
Walk around with your missus for this.
My day, the barber was a counselor, he was a fashion expert, he was a style coach, pimp, just general all-around hustler. I said all them things a long time ago, but I say this here, I'm still pretty.
Peace. Abarigani. Hotep. What's happening? Assalamu alaikum. You are watching the Supremely Faded podcast, the real barbershop podcast. The Supreme Style Barbers are Sayyid, Brian, Travis, Oloyea, and Brother Herman. And they all in the building.
Yeah, y'all.
What is going on?
Hey,
O. Hey, O. Young Papa's in the building.
What's up? What's up?
Oh, it's not in the building.
Sayyid's here.
Hello. Hello.
Hey, Sayyid.
Hey. What's happening?
Yeah, let's get these cameras right. Hold on. Before we get into it. How my cousin's calling?
He don't want nothing.
He don't want nothing. So, we're going to talk about some serious stuff. But before we get into it, we want people to come into the room. Why does he keep calling me? Let's see. First question, because we gotta talk about it. What about them Broncos?
Yeah.
What about them Broncos?
Five straight.
Still going.
Five straight.
Don't change that picture.
Don't change the picture now.
The picture worked out.
Something about that picture.
Something about that pic.
We're gonna leave the picture then, huh? Since I was complaining about the picture, gonna leave the picture.
Oh man.
Sports fans are so superstitious though, man.
For real. They're looking good. And they have Houston next, right?
Houston.
They could beat Houston.
Yeah.
Houston's tough. We play them here? We play them
here? No, we play them in Houston.
In Houston.
Okay. But you know, I don't
Houston's
know
Broncos. Tough.
Broncos seem to have that mojo right now.
That's right.
That mojo.
That mojo.
The mojo. Hello.
Hello, Travis.
Yes, sir. Let's go.
Oh, man.
What's up, Lamont?
What about CU?
Good, you sir.
Oh, it's over. What you mean it's over?
I mean, you know, it's over.
The season's over.
How are we summing up the season?
Good season.
It was a good season.
I mean, everybody's talking about CU.
Yeah, everybody's talking about CU, but we over. You know, yeah, we expected more, but it's right where we needed to be.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? We got four wins this year. Sean Lewis, which was the offensive coordinator, he did take a job at San Diego. He got the head coaching job. Tim, the tight end coach, he resigned. So
okay, a couple coaches left.
Yeah, a couple coaches left, but you know,
yeah,
that's a turnover for the first year.
Yeah, I'm a mathematics guy, and the way I see it, you did four times better than what you did last year.
Right.
Right.
You won four games when last year you only won one. So that is an incredible marked improvement. What's going on with my headphones? Bruce is in the building, Trav.
Hey, lunch money, what it do?
All right, so there's a there is a lot going on in the world. A lot going on. I didn't learn about it until yesterday. Trav, I think, pointed it out. Sayyid may have mentioned it, but T.I. had to choke out his little boy on a live. He had to choke the little dude out.
He had to choke out that little silver spoon.
Right. Choke out little Ricky Schroeder.
Yeah. I stand on business,
cool.
You don't shut your young dumbass up. You don't stand on no business.
I saw a picture of him. Somebody had a meme where he was like, this little school, little uniform on, sweater and stuff, but they got standing on business. He's just.
He want to be a
privileged child, no privileged kids.
Want to be tough, want to be from the streets, get it out the mud. I'm from the ACO.
Right. No, that's Aurora, Colorado.
Get it out the mud. Cut it out. When's it okay to choke your baby out? Is it?
Whenever necessary.
Yeah, whenever necessary.
Before they get too big.
They don't like me too. You don't get choked, you get to talking that shit to me. Yeah. Nah, he got that. He had that coming.
He did. How old is that little boy?
Early 20s, right?
Yeah,
20. Is
he in his 20s? I think he's like probably like 19.
Oh, is he?
Yeah. He's out of high school?
Yeah, he's gone, man.
Okay. Yeah, he gone.
He needed a good job.
He be in the club.
He kind of swole up on his mama
and whatnot.
Yeah, he needed that.
I remember one of my children tried to swell up on their mama.
What you do?
Fuck him up. You thought he was a nigga on the corner of Colfax in Colorado.
Yeah.
My oldest son had to pull me up off of him, man. It was.
Yeah, we've all been through it. I seen Trav go through it a couple of times.
Yeah.
You went through it.
Yeah.
You had to pull the Jim Kelly kick him in the belly on one of your.
Yeah, I swing on him. Not anymore though. I got better.
When they get old enough to start taking on a little bit more things in life, they start, you know, seeing some.
My thing is you.
What?
When you like, okay, I ain't gonna put my hands
is
on
it,
no
is
more.
It,
yeah, that's
so
what
trash.
It is.
I think
that's what it
I'm
is.
I'm like, you know what? I ain't gonna put my hands on you anymore. But you're gonna have to talk, man. You can't talk to me like that, man.
They really got to get out my face, though. You know what I mean?
Right.
You really got to get out my face because I might revert.
I remember you told me a story. You said you hit one of your sons so hard in the shoulder, his body rotated this way, and you caught him in the other shoulder, and he came back this way.
Yeah.
Fast reflexes, brother, huh? That's good.
But they took me there. And it was. but now, hey, you know, it's hard when you're raising sons. You know what I mean? Because they get to that point where they got that testosterone going, and mm-hmm. they think they're tougher than you, and they got a girlfriend. Oh,
but that little boy, that's the T.I. son.
Yeah, he was
how hard he had it.
Right.
While he's chilling in a skybox. At the Atlanta Falcons football game.
Rich. Born rich.
With a silver spoon. His mama said, had a silver spoon in your mouth.
Right.
Your mama,
and you know, your mama said, it's the truth.
Right. I said to my grandma. Yeah, because he cried to go to his grandma because he had a pacifier.
One to suck on a pacifier.
He had a pacifier addiction.
Uh-huh. And you can tell with his teeth.
That's gonna mess up his gangster.
No, you see his teeth though.
Yeah.
That's when he started getting really outspoken when she brought that up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, oh. And he got like, you're exposing me.
Somebody said he got an overbite and an underbite.
Oh yeah, he did.
That passed.
And whoever put them teeth in his mouth needs to get sued.
They need to get their dental license revoked.
Yeah, they did.
He got an over under. He got an over under.
Oh man.
I missed the Ed's teeth.
That's what you said, baby.
Yeah.
That's bad.
I stand on business. Your mama is in a multi-platinum selling R&B group. Your dad is
the king of the South.
King of the South.
Yeah.
Come on.
Come on, man. You ain't get it out the mud. But these kids, they want to get out the mud so bad. You know, as parents, I think we should just start letting these little motherfuckers get out the mud.
Get out the mud.
And just say no. Everything they ask for,
no. Absolutely.
Get it out the mud.
Get out the mud.
Daddy, I need lunch. No.
Get it out the mud.
Get out
Daddy,
the mud.
I'm hungry. No.
Nah.
Go get out the mud.
Right.
Go,
put that on some t-shirts. Get it out the mud.
Go pack up a 23-style with
some out the mud.
Get it out the mud.
Get it out the mud.
Yes. I'm with that.
Don't ask me for shit.
I don't like little privileged children, people. We know a privileged child that ended up very bad.
Yeah, a few of them, man.
Very bad. He got killed because he wanted to be out getting it out the mud so bad.
Get it out the mud.
Dang.
Willie Frank said he needs to stop arguing with the people that brought you in this world. Right on, Willie. Willie Frank.
Mm-hmm. The words, brother Willie.
What else did we want to say here? Okay, so the subject this morning, we're asking ourselves the question, because in the wake of P. Diddy got some sex charges against him that he settled with Cassie, right?
That one.
Now he done...
More than came out,
and he done resigned from his Revolt. Position at Revolt, which is his media company.
Right. So he's trying to save his media company.
Didn't Kanye say this a while back on Drink Champs about Diddy?
He said what?
About his sexual allegations. Did he mention that?
I don't know. That Drink Champs show, I can't really watch. I can't really
watch. Drunk.
They just drink champs, hurt.
Just dumb. What else did I want to say? So P. Diddy. Now Jamie Foxx has allegations. Some little white woman. them filed some sexual assault charges against him that happened in 2015.
Yeah, 2015. He was at a bar on the rooftop. And two ladies were sitting at a table next to him. A lot of people was coming up to his table and they were escorting the people away from his table. But then the girls got a picture with Jamie. Jamie takes one of the girls, you know, more secluded area on the rooftop. And she said he put his hand on her breast. He pulled her to her, went by her waist, put her hands on his hands on her breast. And then his hand was in her pants.
Okay.
So, I mean, you got to kind of be a magician to do all that, like, with no help.
Well, none of us were there, but you know,
unless you're right, using straight right. force, you know what I mean.
And Trav, that made, man,
I could try to stick up for him.
Yeah, yeah.
But then you look at niggas with money; they do a lot of shit. Like they think they're exempt from
and niggas with no regular, money and niggas with regular. No money do a lot of shit.
Like they think they're exempt from being regular dudes. Like they like, man, that's me. Like you shouldn't have smiled at me.
Well, you do have a target on your back when you got some money. So. Yeah,
so you absolutely have.
But you do have some women that look at that as a bag, a potential bag. You know, just
so like, how come it didn't come out in 2015?
That part.
All right.
That part. So, you know, there's this hashtag believe women, which of course we want to believe women. You know what I mean? However, you make a very good point when all you have to do is charge somebody. And so the question, family in the chat room, and Yolanda Adams wanted to send Trav a Cash App. Trav, what's your Cash App?
Uh-oh. Supreme Trav.
Supreme Trav. $Supreme Trav.
No, just tell him to send it to the.
Or you can send it to me, Yolanda, and I'll make sure he gets it.
And send me one while you're sending our money.
I'm honest. So the question is, can a black man survive not a sexual assault, like Sayyid initially put, but a sexual assault charge?
Yeah.
Can a black man survive a sexual assault charge? And this is a question because Big Mike's in the building. What's going on, brother? It's a question because did he settle?
Right.
He settled with Cassie quick. And then there's some more charges.
Michael Jackson settled.
Right. Michael Jackson. Settled. Never been convicted.
These dudes can't. It's like you can't fight this. Like,
but hold up. But if they have the money to go to court and defend themselves,
why wouldn't they defend themselves?
Why won't they defend themselves? You make yourself look worse just by settling.
Because sometimes they don't want to go through this shit. Like Michael Jackson said, I got shit to do, man. Exactly. I feel like going through this. Like,
because
I'm on world tour.
Right.
I don't feel like doing this. So a lot of times the legal will be like, man, just pay her. Just pay her.
Let's get it out the way.
Like Diddy's is $30 million.
He paid her $30 million?
That's a lot of money.
But no, I heard it was your name worth,
I heard it was $100 million.
I heard it was $100 million.
Is your name worth saving? Like, I mean,
is your name worth saving? That's a good question.
That's a good question.
Because if someone is innocent and they say, yeah, let's do this, and then break her ass. And then, you know, like when he's proven innocent,
does it really go away?
You're never proven innocent. That's the problem. You're never proven innocent. That's why the question is, can a black man survive? Because just think about all of the brothers who were charged with sexual assault, but their career is over.
Right.
Right.
They're forever tainted. Even like Michael Jackson was never convicted.
Right.
Of a sexual assault charge. But just the allegation alone caused people to really think that dude is a pedophile.
Has there ever been any situations where a black man has said,
one,
I'm innocent, we're going to court, and he won?
And he won.
Because it was proven that she lied.
I don't know none that really
I don't know who.
Blackman, but the white dude just won.
Who?
That was in court, and the girl was he was just on TV. The actor. It was a white dude. He won, but I never know no black man to win.
Black man ain't going.
I think that's the main thing they could get on the black man, that he cannot win.
Right.
Like, cause think about it. Everybody that tried to go to trial lost. Mike Tyson.
I'll tell you somebody who won.
Who won?
Trump.
Trump.
He ain't black.
I mean, as far as like having allegations, still.
We can name a zillion white men who got sex charges and they good. I mean, Woody Allen literally married his own daughter.
Right.
And he still could make movies. He's still the most, you know what I mean, celebrated director in Hollywood.
Okay.
Trump said it. We grabbing by the, you know what?
Old Spade was like, who's Woody Allen? Oh, like Woody from Toy Story?
I'm
learning something every day. I didn't know that.
Yolanda, I got the Cash App. I'll make sure Trav gets it. I'll send it right over to
Woody
him.
Woody from Toy Story?
Yeah, Woody Allen is a famed so-called Jewish director.
Married his own daughter?
Hey, this is Steve from next door.
Yeah, he had a little South Korean daughter that they adopted when she was like two.
2 years
when
old.
When she turned 17, he started, well, he was messing with her, you know what I'm saying, long before that.
Yeah.
But when she turned 17, going into 18, he married her.
Yeah.
Yep.
Oh, yeah. He should have been up under the jail.
ain't that happening to him?
He ain't got nowhere near the jail.
He ain't got no charges.
Do we got babies with her?
Damn. I don't know.
He might.
But
we're talking about two different worlds.
Yeah, man. White men get away with that all the time. Jimmy Iovine got some charges against him right now. Sexual assault charges.
I bet he win.
He gonna get up out of that. Watch.
Of course he will.
If he went to trial, he'll win.
But Jimmy Iovine's a so-called Jew as well.
But a sexual assault charge on a black man, that funk is gonna follow him for the rest of his life.
Yep.
Well, now when you talk about Bill Cosby,
anything negative on a black dude follows him.
But sexual assault, especially.
Yeah.
Anything that has to do with sex, period.
Yeah.
That you get accused of, especially if you're rich and you're famous and you're black, it's going to be a problem.
Well, media already portrays us as hypersexual people anyway, though. So that is like, well, they just, this is who they are.
Yeah.
Build on that. Where does that come from? Why are we hypersexualized?
Shit, that comes from slavery. That comes from the plantation.
Slavery, when they had us. You need some long fingers. Yeah, that comes from slavery, man.
That comes from breeding farms.
From the excuse of why the plantation owner had so many babies with the lady slaves, in the kitchen.
And this is why they don't believe black women half the time, man, because they like, okay, this is a hypersexual woman and this is who she is. You know, we sexualize her and just anything, man. You know, this is what it is.
And our lady rappers aren't making it any better.
Oh, that's gonna go on to something else.
Uh oh.
Yeah, that's gonna go on to Pound Town.
No, let's go. Isn't that something? So we're like Saeed says, we're hypersexualized as men, we're hypersexualized as women. So you have Sexy Red and, you know, doing all that filth that she does, and the whole community suffers as a result. Mm-hmm. Right. You know what I mean? And they're taking down, because when you think about, okay, entertainment, P. Diddy, Jamie Foxx, these are superstars in entertainment. And a lot of us, a lot of our people ascribe or want to be entertainers like that because of the example that they see in a P. Diddy or a Jamie Foxx. Like, Jamie Foxx is arguably the most talented performer in Hollywood, period. Black or white, hands down. Mm-hmm. Dude is super, uber talented. P. Diddy is, I mean, just, he turned himself into a billionaire really based upon taking old R&B tracks and, you know what I'm saying, linking them with rappers and parlaying that into selling Chirac and Sean John. And I mean, he's a mogul.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And the revolt piece is interesting that he had to give up that particular position because revolt was really one of the only black independent media sources that we have. Right?
Mm. I heard he's trying to buy NBC too.
Who, did he?
Yeah.
I haven't heard that. Yeah, he was trying to buy NBC?
And I'm like, everybody that tried to buy NBC, boy.
Get in trouble.
Right away. You got,
bye, Felicia.
Uh-oh. We're looking out the window, chat room, because the hoes is outside hoeing.
Damn. That's the casket hoe. That's Cascisca. Hey, Peaches.
Oh,
that's Cascisca.
Come on, slide in, Peaches. Slide in, Peaches.
That's Cascisca.
Girl, you better get ready. You got to get ready for this action, this podcast action.
No, she ain't quiet like that.
But another thing with how media portrays white men is that they're not hypersexual. So they're gonna come in with a little bit more of a clean, you know, imagery. You know, this is outside of who they are. They don't do this sort of thing.
When they the freakiest things around.
Freakiest.
Come on, they got a whole history of it.
Freakiest motherfucker.
They got the animalistic freakiness.
Man.
Stick a gerbil in my butt.
That stuff we can't
even imagine. Right? Just stick a gerbil in my butt. Y'all remember George
Michael? Oh, my God.
When George Michael had a gerbil in his butt, didn't he?
Well, no.
But then when you look at black people, we have a history of nation building and kingdoms and, you know, ethics and stuff like that. And then
right.
They switched all that up. Black man can't keep his stuff in his pants.
Like, right.
Yeah, this is who he is. So they're guilty before there's even a charge.
You know, it's interesting, man, because I'm always suspicious when I see charges leveled at entertainers like that.
Yeah.
Because.
Like their numbers up.
Because it's like, you know, regular dudes, you know what I mean? People have their proclivities or whatever, but regular dudes could keep their stuff on the low. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like an everyday dude can keep his stuff on the low.
Until they don't become regular anymore.
Yeah.
But here's the thing. If you got money and you got power and you have all of this influence, dude, I can keep it on the low. You know what I mean? We just doing everything at the house. Ain't no cameras up in here.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? I'm always suspicious when I hear these charges where these real famous people doing stuff in real public places, like the Jamie Foxx piece. Like, it just don't sound right.
I want to know what they're doing, what they're trying to do. Because there's always something that they're trying to do that they're blocking.
Right.
So when the charges come out, somebody's doing something that they block it. They're trying to block it. Like back in the day when Murder Inc., it was Herb Gotti.
Herb Gotti.
Suge Knight,
right?
Jay Prince.
They always trying to formulate a black
distribution. Black distribution.
The only black distribution. If they get that going, then all the black people will go to
exactly.
them, and then that'll cut out somebody's money.
Exactly.
And they
this
don't
was,
want
this
that.
Was this, this was a declaration of war.
They indicted made. Them
mm-hmm.
on like charges, like different charges.
Right.
Irv Gotti went to court and won. He went to he beat the federal government. He won, but he spent like most of his money
right.
doing it.
Oh, so Tyler Perry better watch out, cause.
But you know, to your point, B, that's why Tyler Perry kind of stays very secluded and isolated.
Mm.
You notice he's not around.
He's not around.
He's not
right,
a Hollywood right. type. You know what
right.
I mean? He done built his own Hollywood.
Yep. Atlanta, yeah.
He built it for
he did. Because
you know, you got it. You have to isolate yourself. Because like we talking about sexual assault. Remember, or can a black man survive sexual assault charges? Remember back in the day when they charged Eddie Murphy with picking up the tranny on wherever the hell.
Right.
Like that dude just disappeared. Like he went back to New Jersey. You know what I'm saying? Lived at this. He don't do nothing except take care of them, all them 10 children he got. And he's very private. He because you almost have to be totally isolated to stay away from the attacks.
That brings me up to Russell Simmons. Because
mm-hmm.
he was hit with sexual assault charges. And what did he
yes.
do? That dude went to Bali.
He had to get out.
He started doing yoga.
Yeah.
Well, he's been doing yoga.
He's been doing yoga.
Yeah.
But how?
Oh, that's crazy.
That's so crazy.
It almost seemed like there's a glass ceiling. Like for
you get to a certain point,
you get to a certain point,
and that's come.
Your car get pulled.
You know, it's whether you can withstand the rocks and the thrown at you.
Yeah, mm-hmm. What's that? That movie that Morgan Freeman was in? The girl shot the bullet around the car.
Oh, Wanted.
Wanted. Your number gets pulled.
Yeah.
Like it's like oh shit, and then you look and your number get pulled. Like oh damn. So it's weird. That's crazy.
Mm-hmm.
But you know what, Tyler Perry, though, that's really a chess move on his part, though.
Oh, man. Did you watch the documentary?
I haven't watched the documentary.
Oh, man, gave me so much style respect for that guy.
For real?
Man.
Might make the
cut. I might go back and watch Madea's and stuff now.
Right.
Like, man, that dude was doing
you know, because they even talked about the demasculation of men in dresses.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So they had Martin, they had everybody.
Yeah.
Right.
Oh, they talked about that?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. And Tyler Perry he said that the lady that was playing Madea
was actually his mom.
Up. Yeah. But,
I mean, he didn't show
up.
Yeah.
Show up.
I bet she's kicking herself right now. She's like, damn it, that could have been.
Mm-hmm. Show up. So he had to go in.
He had to play both parts in the play. And that was one of his only shows that kind of flopped.
Yep.
You know what I'm saying? But what he did, he went and wrote and made the story just about Madea, so he wouldn't have to do too many changes. So that's how Madea came about. It was, man, it had me a whole.
Look at Herman.
I know you don't want to
hear it. We don't want to hear it.
Hey. Hey.
Y'all really believe that.
We don't want to hear it again. No, for real.
I do.
No, because people was like, after the show, they was like, what the hell did I just watch?
And how he did what he did, man, that had me have a whole newfound respect for that guy. That dude did it right.
Well, you know, Tyler Perry deserves our respect, man.
I know.
Just because he's creating his own.
In terms of his business acumen, he's brilliant, man. Mm-hmm. And in terms of what he's been able to do for Black Hollywood, and it's unparalleled. You know
right.
what I mean? No one's ever been able to do what he's done, and he's done it like B was saying, independently.
Independently,
you know what
I'm saying?
He's
doing
everything.
His own money.
He's funding his own enterprises, which is exactly what we all want to do. So Tyler Perry gets mad respect.
No, mad respect.
Staying away from
from
Hollywood and those Yahoodis.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you off the radar. You know, you're off the radar. Even if they wanted to pin something on him, they might have a hard time trying to find something on him.
Well, I think they should make a law like when those when people come out and they, like Bill Cosby.
Mm-hmm.
Bill Cosby money in the 60s, it was good money. But I don't think you should come in 2000-something and go get millions when he didn't have that shit in the 60s.
Right.
You sue him for his bank records from the 60s, mm-hmm. and that's what you get to get.
Okay, so what's the question is,
how do we prevent blew all the way up
this from happening now? Like, you know, what would be some of the preventions?
It got to be a law. It got to be a law, a statute of limitation.
In terms of sexual assault?
It is a statute of limitation.
No, it's not.
Well, man,
it doesn't start seem like now. There is.
There's a new law starting.
No, it's they talking about 30 years, man. People can go back 30 years.
No, there's a new law starting in New York. That's why everything's coming out now. There's a new law that's starting.
I was listening to
New York. That's why all these allegations on everybody is coming out now.
They was talking about this statute of limitation law can go back 30 years. Now, who the hell will remember some shit you did 30 years ago?
Right. Exactly.
Rainey said in New York there is a statute of limitation. She also asked, have we ever seen Tyler Perry Studios? I've seen it on TV. I've never seen it in real life.
Rainey, how long, how many years is that statute of limitation in New York?
The new law.
If you could find that, put it in the chat if you could.
Yeah, there's a new law that's cutting it off now. Like, the statute is, I don't know,
30 years?
No, it ain't 30. It used to be 30.
Shit, that's like murder. Like, I'm 20 years old at 30 years ago. I'm like, what was I doing? Like,
right. And see, that part was, right there. Like, that part you? Right there. Because when we talk about, like, okay, like Bill Cosby, right? I was outraged at what they did to Bill Cosby.
Yeah, I was mad at his lawyer.
And that's not to say that I'm a person who says that we shouldn't believe women, because I think we should believe women.
Right.
However, when you talk about something that happened 40 years ago, when you were in a pill-popping culture,
yeah.
And now you say, and then a lot of these women, they were literally living off of Bill Cosby. Like, right. They had apartments, they had cars,
right.
They had this and that and the third. They was Bill Cosby's little pieces.
So they signed up for that.
he drugged me and had sex with me 40 years ago. And my problem with that is, for one, 40 years ago, really? If you ask me what I did 4 or 5 years ago on any given night,
right?
I can't remember nothing.
Right. But 40 years ago, there was no name. There was no date rape.
Can you imagine?
There was no Ruthie's. There was no.
Can you imagine if you had someone like Richard Pryor still alive today, what would be happening to him?
Oh, wait.
Richard Pryor is on record talking about he used to put cocaine on himself before he would have sex with women.
Mm.
That was a part of the party life. That LA party life.
That was that 70s scene. You know what I'm saying? I mean,
cocaine on yourself.
It's crazy.
I tried that shit one time, man.
Did it work?
What happened?
I was young. He was like, why is everything numb? Oh,
you should be like, so you had been cocaine.
No, never.
Yeah, but I find that very problematic, man. Like, you know what I mean? Like, the Jamie Foxx thing is going back to 2015.
Right.
Diddy goes way back to 2003. Like,
yeah. 20 years ago.
Come on, man.
Yeah.
About to be 21 years ago.
Well, you know, Cassie had a lot of witnesses. Like,
but
she still had witnesses.
That's not to say that they didn't do these things, though.
Yeah.
That's not what we're saying.
I think Diddy did all that shit.
And some.
And
some,
right?
That's why I'm trying to cover that right now.
I wouldn't know if I was worth Bentley to come out and be like, look.
They might kill
the other side of this.
Mm-hmm. Oh, man.
Because I heard Fonz was his boyfriend.
His manservant. That's his
manservant.
He made him disappear quick, though, huh?
Mm-hmm. Gave him an umbrella and said, go.
Like Mary Poppins.
Yeah. You ain't seen that nigga.
Mary Poppins.
You can't catch that nigga in a rainstorm.
So when you said that it was 20-year limit as of 2023.
That's why, Trav's point, that's why it came out, right? Because they're changing the law.
So somebody was like, they probably was sitting on it and like, you better tell that story.
You better say, hurry up and say something.
Get this right money.
And he gonna settle with you, like, girl. He gonna settle with you, girl.
So, what did he get? What did he get, Cassie? 100 or 30 million?
I don't know.
100 million?
I heard.
I said you got 100 million.
Yeah, I heard he got 100 million.
100.
What does she know?
Honey.
100 million? 100
million. Honey.
What are you being quiet about, Cassie?
Kaepernick money.
Cassie about to be dead.
No, Cassie about to be gone.
If Cassie don't move out of the country, she gonna be gone.
Cassie got security. She could afford it.
Hey, you heard Diddy put a bomb on what's his name's car.
They said Diddy's a gangster.
They out here today.
But, hey, Trav's right. I think Diddy must have been on to something. He was about to do something big.
Yeah.
Because they came after him real hard.
He about to do something monumental.
No, Espanol. No, go on.
Yeah, they came after him real hard.
I think him. Jamie Foxx, Will Smith. I think all the dudes is like.
We only go by appointment.
Because you got to think, like, all of them is in the music. Don't forget about Will Smith for music.
Look, Wallin said, good morning, Wallin. She said, penal code 799B.
All right.
Indicates that the California rape statute of limitations doesn't exist because the prosecution can commence at any time. Consequently, the prosecution can take their time gathering evidence until they have enough to convict before filing charges.
So they can take as much time as they want.
Hey, can y'all check New York?
You were 16 years old. You might be 70 years old. Did something at 16.
You might have rubbed on a little girl's booty when you was 10.
Right. Check New York. Oh, no. They
mama ain't mad at his ass.
No, they be filing charges against kids in like daycare. Shit like that.
What?
Yeah, the parents be like, have to go deal with that.
Yeah. In schools now, yeah.
Real talk.
Mm-mm-mm. Randy said, did you see Diddy erasing stuff off of Kim's cell phone when she died?
No, I believe it, though.
Wow.
Kim knows something. Kim got that book coming out. Kamora Lee's going to finish this book, I guess.
Kamora Lee?
She going to finish Kim's book?
Yeah.
Kamora Lee's going to be
make sure to... She better go. She better go where her husband is. Hey.
Get your affairs in order.
Yeah.
Oh man.
It ain't Diddy no more. It's Daddy.
Oh,
Brandon was on it. Tell your guy Habla Despacio.
Despacio.
Despacio. She need to be the next co-host with the Como. She gonna tell
him. Yeah,
Randy,
come
get your
up
ass
here.
Up out of here.
Bring them girls up in here, Randy. You can go sit down with us.
Underlay, get your ass up out of here. Bring your babies. Come on and come chill.
Come on, join the. Get in the chair.
They visited us yesterday.
They were there yesterday.
Yeah, we saw the girls yesterday.
They was
little ladies
doing
getting their training
in from dad while he was.
Yeah, they're dope. They're dope. Yeah, I don't know, man.
It's going to come out what he was trying to do.
What if he's just slimy, y'all?
Maybe he is.
He is slimy.
But maybe he's not.
I mean, what if he is?
But what if he's not?
I think he is.
See, that's the danger, though. Because if they can say Diddy's slimy, they can say anybody's slimy.
Can you not be slimy and get to that status in life?
That's a good question.
Huh? That's you got to have some slime.
You got to have some dirt on you.
He might not be slimy. He might just be gay.
What? Oh, you almost got me. You got me.
Almost pulled me in. I ain't going to.
He might just be just gay. But my thing is, why do they tell?
What they got to do with him putting the bomb on the Kid Cudi's car and all this?
That he's a jealous gay dude. He's bi. I done heard too many stories about Diddy, like
Like, well, what?
Okay, but is that okay? You could be bi, you could be tranny, you could be whatever. Don't nobody care.
Right,
that's,
no, no.
That's awesome.
That's the thing. You can be whatever. But if you're a black dude in the face of like hip hop,
you can't be.
Why do they throw the whole gay thing out there now? When you can be whatever you want. But now, the first thing we heard about Will's gay. First thing we heard about Diddy's gay. That's hip hop. That goes against the rules of hip hop. So they want black people to jump on board with canceling you first. That's how you get canceled.
You get canceled by your own people. And then.
Exactly. And it's easy because white people going to already be behind it. The canceling comes from us.
And it does.
You see how Kanye? We canceled Kanye. We was like, fuck y'all, he ain't canceling Kanye.
They
canceled Kanye, but then they had to bring him back. Come on, man. It starts with us. The cancel culture is
Kyrie
us.
Irving.
It does, but we're not even going to counsel you for being gay.
No, we're not.
But in hip hop, like hip hop fans be like, nah, that ain't cool. How many gay football players you see?
I'm sure there's a bunch of them.
What? They just got that one dude from the Raiders.
And his ass retired right after he came out.
He still plays for them.
No, he don't.
Yes, he do.
Look him up right now. Look at him right now.
Just like Birdman, we've been knowing he was something freaky.
Birdman.
You know what I'm
saying? Yeah.
It didn't come out like that. It didn't come out that he been out the league.
But he had that reputation of messing with little boys. They don't even care if you mess with little boys. You know what I mean? They don't tear you down for that. It's sexual assault against women.
Yeah.
Particularly white women. That's when you get ripped. If you messing with little boys, don't nobody care.
Right.
Birdman been doing that forever.
Forever. Right.
Right.
They been talking about that. He's still, you know what I'm saying?
He's still in movies. He's still there. Right.
But you mess with a white woman.
Lil Wayne and
y'all saw
BG get out of jail recently.
Oh yeah,
he was flipping that hair like he was.
Yeah.
BG is being a girl.
That's what it
being
is.
A girl.
Oh man.
No. So what about the basketball player now that facing the sexual assault against the little 16-year-old?
Is it Josh Giddey?
Ain't nothing gonna happen to him. Same as nothing happened to Roethlisberger.
Ain't nothing
gonna happen to these people, man.
And he's in the picture with the 16-year-old, like
white girl.
Yeah.
Oh, he's in trouble.
But he's a white guy.
Yeah. Well, he's a white guy.
Yeah. Oh, he's white good. Guy. He's a white guy.
That's like I said, Ben Roethlisberger, man. How long we been talking about him?
Okay, so he's like 23.
How long have we been talking about him?
And she's like 16.
Oh, he good.
But that happened to Anthony Anderson, Birdman.
Same thing
to him.
Ben Roethlisberger had about several women come out. They didn't punish him. Matter of fact, it was a restaurant in Denver created a burger after him.
Yep.
The Roethlisberger.
Do y'all remember remember when Jamie Foxx, this is just an illustration of how it has to be about black men and white women for whatever reason. Because remember when he started dating Tom Cruise's wife?
Katie Holmes. Yeah.
And how the public was like.
It was just so weird.
It was so weird. Right? And so now, first of all, Jamie disappeared for I don't know how long. We haven't seen this dude in forever. Like, have y'all seen Jamie Foxx?
Not since he cut that
The Barrier, that movie. That was like
The Barrier, yeah, but that was
well, right, right, but that was filmed before
he got sick.
Yeah.
We haven't seen him since he got sick, right?
So is he sick?
Uh-oh.
Or is he saying I'm sick?
Let's stay on topic, y'all. Here we go.
Leave me alone, I'm sick.
We on topic though.
But how have we seen him?
We haven't seen him.
We need proof of life.
But now they come out with a sexual assault charge. And we haven't even seen this dude.
Right.
A sexual assault charge on a white woman in 2015. So what's that narrative shaping up to be?
Hey, we'll delete you.
Where is Jamie?
They try to kill him and give him a a code he couldn't get over.
They try to blame that on Diddy.
They did. They been trying to blame everything on Diddy.
Blame it on Diddy, y'all. Let's just do this.
Man, Blame it on Diddy.
I just hope Deion Sanders has kept his record pretty clean his whole life, man. You know,
DM
never drank, so that's where the bad decisions are created.
And this is why they're mad at him because they can't
alcohol and drugs.
The only thing happened to
DM. That's an excellent point. Like with all of these instances with Jamie Foxx, what was he doing? He was drinking. With Bill Cosby. He's drinking and drugging. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
All these instances got to do with people indulging in these different substances.
Yep.
Which Deion, of course, don't do. He's square as they come.
Yep. You know what I'm saying? But he's still the life of the party.
Exactly.
Well, you remember when Deion supposedly drove his car off the cliff, like trying to commit suicide or whatever it was.
Well, who?
Allegedly, Deion.
Deion Sanders. He tried to kill himself.
No, he said he was praying and he just lost control.
Well, yeah, the tabloid didn't say it.
Yeah.
The tabloid's just like, he tried to commit suicide and all this. But he lived, so I think that's the only, like, really thing they can talk about.
Right. I think white women are off limits, though.
I think he's going through a divorce or something.
Y'all leave these white women alone. For real, because you can mess with anybody.
In the name of Emmett Till.
Man.
Yeah.
I mean.
As soon as you dibble and dabble.
Man, they coming.
They coming for you. Huh?
They are coming. So, I don't know, man. I don't know. Can a black man survive? Survive a sexual assault charge?
No.
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 No, I mean we can't.
Rainey said he could with the right representation, but we don't have no representation.
What representation is that?
It's hearsay, and they don't ever believe us. They don't ever believe the men.
Even if you win and you prove woman a liar, somebody gonna believe her. You see what I'm saying? Like you're not coming out unscathed,
right?
But this is the thing. They said this is the second time the same lady is charging Jamie.
Well, she must be telling the truth. She a white woman or she a sister?
She white. You know she white.
All them girls he done raped that was black.
Well, I don't think she was white because her name was Jamie Doe, her.
But you know what? That's all. But that's all Jamie messed with though. That's his.
Yeah.
That's his thing.
Who, Jamie Foxx?
Yeah, he don't mess with no sisters.
No?
No.
In the movies, he be booed up and married to him, but in real life, he be like,
His daughter's black. Katie Holmes.
His daughter's biracial. His daughter's biracial.
He messed with some black women.
I did not know that.
Jamie. That's why he calls himself Jamie. Jamie Summers. Bionic woman.
Jamie Summers.
Man, his name is Eric Bishop.
Eric Bishop.
Eric Bishop.
He sound like somebody that was raised on the east side.
Oh, Mrs. Adams said, look at Jonathan Majors at the highlight of his career. There goes another one.
Yes.
So did he won that, right? Or did he even go to trial?
It don't matter.
It don't matter.
It don't matter.
I don't think they go to trial.
That's why P. Diddy, like, I ain't going to court.
Yeah. look at Nate Parker.
Yeah, it don't matter, man. Jonathan Majors, man, that white woman accused him, and it was over. I think he did beat it, too. I think somehow.
Would the charges drop?
I think maybe. He paid it.
Think he paid it?
He might have paid it off.
Whatever the case may be. Okay, Wallin said Majors has pleaded not guilty. If convicted, he could serve up to a year in prison.
Whew. Oh, so they haven't even gone to court yet.
They haven't gone to court.
All right, we're going to follow his. If he wins,
hey, man.
He'll be the first.
Just stick with Megan Good, brother. Just stick with Megan Good. Just don't you right there.
Jonathan Majors.
Mm-hmm. And then Nate Parker, when he tried to come out with the Nat Turner movie, that.
Oh, they said something about
that. He got off.
Who? Oh,
Nate Parker. Did he got off.
Or did he pay him off?
No. He was in college when that happened.
Oh, so.
How's his career doing?
Oh, you ain't seen him in another movie since.
He's Spider-Man. No, that's Peter. That's Peter Parker.
It don't matter. It don't matter.
It don't matter.
It don't matter. The system.
You can't survive. Your career is a rap.
His career was rolling too, and he started directing. And he I'm coming out with the Nat Turner movie, and all that started coming out.
All that came out.
Trial he went to and was found innocent. The girl was lying. The girl was lying, and she ended up dying.
Woo.
Damn. She ended up dying, and then
she died, and his career died.
So did.
You ain't seen him that's on a commercial. You ain't seen him on a.
That's
wow. One.
Didn't something like that happen to Isaiah Washington?
Yeah.
He came out with the.
Yeah. But Isaiah Washington.
He did the gays.
That's what messed him up. That's what killed him. Killed his career.
Oh, he is blackballed out of Hollywood right now.
Man. Oh, he's Thuski.
Dang.
You better go hook up with Tyler.
Yeah, I would. Yeah.
I'm going to hook up with Tyler. Tyler got
something.
Yeah, Tyler got something for everybody, man. He be having all sorts of black people in them little B movies he doing.
Uh-huh. He put one out every week.
Yeah, he got
right. I'm telling you.
Hey, that's what it is, though, man. Yolanda asked, how many white men have survived sexual assault?
All of them.
Charged against a black woman.
Against a black woman? Please. All of them.
Right. That ain't even a thing. Is that even a thing?
No, they gave me they gave all the $50,000. You ain't never heard nothing else.
Yeah, I don't know.
Who else is that? It's like just giving the girl $50,000. Was it the coach?
I don't know.
Somebody black just giving the girl. He said, "Now, you think I'll give you $50,000 a week, a month?"
Yeah. Do black women charge white men with sexual assault? Is that a thing?
I'm sure they do.
No, they don't.
No, they don't.
They be like, he was just playing.
He liked me. We got to get something started. That would be very interesting. That would be very interesting because, you know.
Black woman and in charge of white man.
All they say is prove it.
Right.
But when it comes to a black man, it'd be white and black, Hispanic, Asian be coming after this.
Because with black women who are usually with white men, black women usually run their ass. You know what I'm saying? I mean,
right.
They run white dudes.
Star Trek?
Like, run they.
You know the lady who's with the Star Trek guy?
Nichelle Nichols?
Yeah.
She ran her dude. She charged a white man for sexual assault?
No. I'm just saying, she runs her dude.
Nichelle Nichols? The old black lady?
The whore.
The new one or the old one? The first one.
The first one.
She was married to a white dude?
I don't know.
No, she wasn't married to no white dude.
She's 100 years old. Her name was Yohuru.
No, she was not married to no.
No.
Yeah, I think
Yolanda
so,
said, wow, see, that stereotype shit is crazy. We stereotyping. I mean, I'm just usually. I wouldn't say 100% of the time, but 99.9.
You are the father.
I'm sure there's some black women that have, accused white men of sexual assault somewhere.
And got fired.
Right.
Right.
Yeah, man.
got let go.
All right. I got one black dude.
We're gonna let you go.
Hold up. Before we go, I got one black dude that won. Ooh. Clarence Thomas.
But that was a black woman, though.
That, I don't care.
It was a black woman.
In the hell I told you. Clarence Thomas, man. I was trying to find one at one. Clarence Thomas.
Oh, my God. No, man. No, Trap.
On Anita Hill?
She black.
I know, but he won.
But hold up.
We trying to find one that won.
Hold up. My wife just said Harvey Weinstein was
Harvey
convicted.
Weinstein was convicted.
Were there black women that was accusing him of?
No. Just white women.
I thought it was a sister in there somewhere.
Hey, Harvey had too much information.
She didn't count.
Harvey had everybody else's information. He was harboring everybody else's information. So
yeah, I think they pulled Harvey Weinstein's card, Trav was saying. He did something.
And he didn't kill himself.
Somebody.
Because white men will kill themselves real quick.
Mm-hmm.
They could be standing in trial, and they'd be going in there to bring them into court, and that nigga is hanging from the...
Hey, he got no chair up under him.
When he gets to his house,
that nigga hanging from the doorknob, man. Like, hey,
they got a whole sheet, man. When he gets to his cell, they like, here, man.
He just had eight sheets delivered to his cell last night.
Here you go, homie. Here you go.
That nigga is slinging his with a butter knife, a plastic butter knife.
Here's the chair. Here you go, homie. Right there. Go ahead, man.
The
plant hanger right there, man. This is
it,
man.
Nah, he had no butter knife. He had Ginsu knife.
Why does it kill their ass? Boy, that question get on the white man. That thing is so
old.
Oh,
my God.
Yeah, I can't do it.
Sip that secret soup.
Yeah. I'm out.
Oh, I got a traffic ticket. That dude walked in the traffic.
Yeah.
I can't take it.
We're done.
White man can't take no pressure, God. Man.
No.
Unless he a goddamn Navy SEAL or some shit. He got to do
right.
Right. One of them.
Oh, man.
A sexual assault. All right, I'm out of here.
We're out of time. We got to go.
I got Phil. Hey, up. Got my head.
Oh, my God. Travis leaving. Oh, my God. On a serious note. Woo. Lord. Oh, my God.
Man.
Get the latest final call. It's got our brother, may Allah be pleased with him, Brother Joshua Farrakhan. You can get that at the barbershop. I want to invite you guys. Oh, man. These dudes are crazy. Where are we at? 2-hour meeting on Sunday, Nation of Islam Denver Study Group 4651 Tulsa. Please join us. We gotta get out. I'm done. We'll see y'all next time. Remember, if you don't stand for something, you'll fall for anything. Say good morning, Supreme Style Barbers.
Good morning.
Good morning. Peace, y'all.
See y'all on the next one.
Peace.
Thanks for watching, guys. We both love and appreciate you for doing so, but we need for you to take some action and do us one or two or maybe three more favors. And that is, go ahead and smash that like button, share it if you really dig the video, and also subscribe. That way you'll get a bell ding, a notification every time we post something, and it also helps us with regards to the algorithm that your people like to run. So go ahead and do that, and we'll see y'all on the next one. Peace.
Peace, everybody. It's your brother Herman, Supreme Style Muhammad. Just wanted to drop in and let you know what we have going on. In addition to our community work that we've been doing for years, and in addition to being the sole proprietor of Supreme Style Barbershop, where we've been serving the community for close to 25 years. Now we've partnered up with an insurance company called Ethos in an effort to help our people with life insurance. That's something that we all need. I know it's something that we don't want to think about, but it is something that we all need if we want to leave anything to our loved ones when we leave this space. So do me a favor, click on the link or go to our website, astar2.com, and click on the Ethos page. We'll see you on the other side.